And I invite you just to pause right where you are, to close your eyes, and to take a deep breath. What are you hungry for? What are you hoping for? What are you seeking? What sparks your curiosity? What ignites your passion? What opens your heart? Creator God, we ask that you would be with us this evening on this beautiful, mystical night, the night that we remember your birth. Guide our hearts, our minds, our souls, and our bodies into your peace. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. And now, welcome. Let us rise together and welcome the Lord of life. Come, let us adore him. And now, before you sit down, I want to invite you to take some bells, because for these next two songs, we're going to need some bells. Would somebody help me pass them down? We have a wonderful grandma here. Ravi, would you help pass them down for anybody who needs them? We've got some more bells. Here we go. More bells for everyone. We're going to jingle some bells. Amen. help yourself and then pass them back for whoever needs them. I have my nice Jesus tambourine. So just before we get into this holy song of Jingle Bells, I want to ask you, what do you call people who are afraid of Santa Claus? Claustrophobic. That was kind of a dad joke. But. All right, we have an opportunity to, whenever we gather, to awaken the child within us. And so this is an opportunity, whether you're 2 or 92 or older or younger, just to join for fun in singing Jingle Bells. And there is a verse written just for us here in Woodside. And turn to somebody near you, and you can do it with a fist bump, or if you're comfortable with a hug, make sure both people are comfortable. If you want to do a high five, if you want to just wave, pass a sign of peace and say, peace be with you, 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 peace. Merry Christmas, peace be with you. Hear the teaching of Christ, a new commandment I give you. Love one another as I have loved you. The peace of Christ be with you all and also with you. And now, Rudolph, the red-nosed reindeer. We can keep our bells for this one, too.
Oh.
And now if we could have the baskets gather up, if a few folks would help gather up the bells, that would be wonderful. And while they're gathering up the bells with the choir, come on up. And Mark also, after your bells are gathered, please have a seat. I know Deacon Mark Dickey is in the house.
Galatians chapter 4, verses 4 and 5 says, "When the right time came, God sent his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those under the law, so that we might be adopted as God's sons and daughters. On this Christmas Eve, we honor the God of hope, the Prince of Peace, the God of love, and the source of joy. We light the Christ candle for the one who comes to give us hope, peace, love, and joy in his name, so we can shine with his light in the world. Will you join me in prayer? Light of the world, shine through me.
Lights of the world,
shine through us. In Jesus' name, amen.
And here's a reading from Isaiah 9, verses 2 to 7. Part of this, you're going to know the words, and I can't read them without singing them. So if you want to sing along, go ahead. "The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of the shadow of death, a light has dawned. You have enlarged the nation and increased its joy. The people rejoice before you as they rejoice at harvest time, as victors rejoice as they divide the plunder. For as the day in the Midian, you have shattered the yoke of their burden, the bar across their shoulders, and the rod of their oppressor. And for every trampling boot of battle, with every garment rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for fire. For unto us a child is born, unto us a child is given, unto us a child is born. And the government will be upon his shoulders, and the one called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace, there will be no end. He will reign on the throne of David and over his kingdom, to establish and sustain it with justice and righteousness from that time and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of the angel armies will accomplish this. Amen."
Thank you.
Joseph Martinez. Joseph, come on.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place. While Quirinius was governor of Syria, everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up to the town of Nazareth in Galilee, to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house of lineage of David. Joseph went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a baby.
Shepherds kept their watching, or silent flocks by night. Behold, throughout the heavens, there shone a holy light.
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and down in a lonely manger, our humble Christ was born, and God gave us salvation that blessed Christmas morn. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus.
While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
Kathy Waddell.
Hear the revelation to the shepherds from the Gospel according to Luke, chapter 2, verses 8 through 14. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring good news of great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to all people of goodwill."
Hear the song of praise from Psalm 96. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Sing to the Lord, praise his name. Proclaim his salvation day after day. Declare his glory among the nations and his marvelous deeds among the peoples. For great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Honor and majesty surround him. Strength and beauty fill his sanctuary. O nations of the world, recognize the Lord. Recognize that the Lord is glorious and strong. Give to the Lord the glory he deserves. Bring your offering and come into his courts. Worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness. Let all the whole earth tremble before him. Tell all the nations, the Lord reigns. God will judge all people fairly. Let the heavens rejoice and the earth be glad. Let the sea and everything in it shout his praise. Let the fields and their crops burst forth in jubilation. Let the trees of the forest sing for joy. Let all creation rejoice before the Lord, for he comes. He comes to judge the earth. He will judge the world with justice and the nations with his truth.
Good evening. We're so glad you're here. Thank you for coming. My name's Charlie, and I'm new here. And if you're new, we're so glad you're here. Your gift to us is your presence, that you would take a step of faith and say, come and worship with us here on Christmas Eve. I'm able to serve as a pastor in residence with Ama, and it just means I just do whatever Ama says, and it's just great, and it works out really well for me. But we're really glad that you're here, and we're going to take an offering, and you could see clearly that this church has been investing in children, in students, and singing. Wouldn't you agree? Can we just give a big hand to everybody who's been participating? I just think it's been so wonderful, and that has been a blessing to us, and so the usher's going to come forward and receive our offering. This is a practice of our faith. To bring our gifts and our offering, but if you're a guest and you're new here, and we hope you don't feel any obligation. But I also want to let it took a step of faith to be here. I want to mention something that the church is doing, and that's for those of you that have been involved here for a little while, and that is to maybe take a step of faith of being a covenant partner. And I invite you to consider that. Christmas is a great time to take steps of faith. Jesus is very apparent to us, and so I invite you to consider that as we receive this song and we receive your gifts and your offering.
Thank you. Yes, Lord, for the rest of our days. Yes. Yes, Lord, for the rest of our days. Yes. Yes, Lord.
Clapping. Way to go. I just thought there's a lot of beautiful energy. I have one more invitation, and that is that if you're looking for a spiritual home, Woodside Village is a wonderful spiritual home. And I just hope that you would consider that. And we'd love to talk to you about that if you're looking for a place to be a part of a community. And I'm grateful for the team here and the people here. And we found it as a spiritual home for us. So I get to read from Matthew chapter 1, verses 18 to 25. It's the birth of Emmanuel. Emmanuel means God with us. And it's from Matthew's gospel, and it says this. This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. May God bless his word to us tonight.
Did you know that your baby boy one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you of God, oh Mary, did you know?
are so blessed to have so many amazing musicians here. Can we again just appreciate each one of them? Amen. There's an old saint, Hildegard of Bingen, who said, the one who sings prays twice, because you've got the words and then you've got just the heart opening with song. So now hear this word from the book of Revelation, chapter 21, verse 3. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, look, God's dwelling place is now among the people, and he will dwell with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death, or mourning, or crying, or pain. For the old order of things has passed away. He who was seated on the throne said, behold, I am making everything new. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Merry Christmas. God is making everything new. And yet, sometimes we can't see it. And we can feel so alone. Maybe I feel alone in trying to be a good person. Other people cut corners. Others encourage me, especially the media, to think only of myself. And I don't want to do that, but maybe I should. Am I alone in trying to do good? Maybe I feel alone in trying to take care of everything on my plate. Who else will feed my children, take them to school, take them to all their lessons? Who will sit down and do my bills? Any volunteers? Who will clean my house and do my dishes every day? Who will make the calls I need to make? Who will handle the business I need to handle? It's overwhelming, and maybe I feel alone. Maybe I feel alone because I've worked so hard, and maybe people don't appreciate everything I've done. They don't see what I do. They don't understand the cost I bear. Everyone's focused on their own challenges, and they don't see mine. I keep working so hard. Who cares? Am I all alone? Maybe I feel alone because people I love are gone. I hope you had a mother's love somewhere in your life. Perhaps you were blessed to have your birth mother give you that love. Perhaps you were blessed to receive it from a woman who chose to mother you. But what happens when that person passes on? Nadie como mama. Who loves you like your mother? Perhaps you've lost your father, a spouse, a friend, a child. Maybe I feel alone because the one I want to love hasn't arrived yet. Do you need anybody? I need somebody to love. And if that's your song, then what do you do if you need somebody to love and you want somebody to love and that person is not in your life yet? Maybe you feel alone. Or what if you found the person and you know they're the person and you love them, but sometimes you still feel alone? No person can meet all of my needs, regardless of what Hallmark cards or Disney movies might say. And feeling alone when you're with someone can be a deep loneliness. So what do we do? No one likes to be lonely, especially at Christmas time. And the media picks up the refrain, it's the most wonderful time of the year. For who? 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 Who is not stressed? Who is not lonely or scared? Who is not struggling in some way? Who? If you are not today, amen. If you made it to church with no scuffles, no arguments, if all your presents are wrapped and your house is beautiful, if you get along with every member of your extended family, if you're feeling healthy and rested, that's a Christmas miracle right there. For most of us, there's something we're wrestling with that is made even harder right now at Christmas time. At this precious time of the year. And the invitation of Christmas is this. Don't run from the loneliness. Don't run away from the loneliness. Don't run to alcohol or sugar. Don't run to judgment and self-righteousness. Don't run to self-blame or perfectionism. Don't run from the loneliness. The loneliness is the manger. The stark and bare manger. It's not a beautiful, fancy hotel. The pillows aren't made of 100% cotton. With sheets turned down and a mint on the pillow. and extra warm blankets for Mary and Joseph and the baby. All there is the manger. This is where Christ is born. This is where Christ is born.
Kingdom.
Christmas Eve, we remember those who have passed on the previous year and those who are still in our hearts. So I'm going to start with reading some of the dedications that we have. And then if you would like to come up, if there's someone particularly that's on your heart, if you'd like to come up and light a candle for them and put it in the sand, I'll invite you to do that in just a moment. Set a dedication for the beloved friend of Mary Norbeck, for a beloved friend of Amy Smith, for Cindy's mother, Sandy Borden, and her mother, Ginny Warren, for Christy Rice, for her father, Jim Rice, Julie Thomas, for their parents, for Susie Kay, for Reverend C.B. Matthews, for Aldo, for George and Peter, from Bob Mullen, for Polly Mullen, for George Lutcha, for Betty and Bob Pultman and Dottie Fifield, for Maeva Neal and Peter Hopcraft, for Terry Stoker and Beverly Murat, for beloved members of this church who have passed, for Vic Frederick, Benny Quist, Dolores Stegman, Dolores Hatzitz, Deacon Chet Yee. If there's someone on your heart that you would like to come up and light a candle for, you can do that. Thank you. We usually celebrate communion when we gather, but just with everybody, I know probably all of you know a number of people, including some who were supposed to be here tonight who might have COVID or flu or something. So we're going to do communion virtually this evening. So I invite you just to pause where you are. And I like to put my hands right on my heart. If you want to do that, you can as well. On the night that Jesus gathered with his disciples, he took the bread and broke it and gave it to them and said, "This is my body, which is for you." Likewise, at the end of the meal, he took the cup and he said, "This is the cup of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and for many for forgiveness of sin." And so now just we receive. And I invite you to receive into your heart, into your mind, into your spirit, into your body, the healing, precious, transforming love of the Holy Lord Jesus Christ. Drinking it in, feasting on it as we receive this gift of song.
Angels, we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains and the mountains in reply, echoing their
in excelsis Deo.
shall cease.
Amen. Thank you so much, Tammy. Amen. And now we are going to come forward, receive a candle, and then form a circle all around the outside of the sanctuary. So I've got some baskets here. So come on up, get a candle, and then come around. Will you help me hand out candles right here, sweetie? If you hold this basket, it matches your dress. Beautiful. Great. And then take a candle, Christy. Amen. Great. Here. Stay up here with me. You. Yeah. Thank you. light from hand to hand. When everyone has the light, let's sing it one more time together, Silent Night. May there be joy to the world. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. And now, joy to the world. Thank you. church part of your year in 2023, that you will grow in God's love, that you will come to a place where you can feel God with you. God is with us, Emmanuel. And that you will find a home, a spiritual home, right here at Woodside Village Church. We do not have a service tomorrow. We also are not having a service on New Year's Day. Our next service will be Covenant Sunday on January 8th. And so we'll be gathering, weather permitting, out in the courtyard, or if it's cold and blustery, maybe right here, or in the chapel. So depending on a number of things, but somewhere here on the campus, we'll be gathering for worship on January 8th. For those of you who would like to be covenant partners, you will find more about that in our e-news. If you are not getting our e-news, or if you're here for the first time, you please do fill out a welcome card. That way we can stay in touch. And also make sure that you get a mug that you can enjoy. And as you drink, remember that God loves you and that there is a home full of God's love for you right here at Woodside Village Church. And now, may you say it again? Yes, absolutely. Thank you. Right after this, anybody who would like to stay and join, continue the festivities, maybe we'll do some more singing. There's a few more carols, right? There's maybe some of your favorites that we didn't sing so far, but we still can in Guildhall. So I hope that you will stay, have some hot cider and or mulled wine and a cookie or whatever goodies there are over there in Guildhall before you head out for the evening. So please feel free to join us if that's something that you'd like to do. And now, in the name of the Creator of all life, of the Holy Lord Jesus Christ, born in a manger, and of the Holy Spirit, go forth in peace and love to the sound of the jingling bells and the sound of angels' wings, to share that love, peace, hope, and joy with all the world. May it be so. Amen.